Howdy and welcome to the walkthrough of the new Roll20 Dungeons & Dragons Character Sheet. This is your in-depth look at the alpha version. No need for a rich backstory here. The names of the game is customization, meaning we cover all of your homebrew choices, and automation, meaning we do the math for you. We have pre-generated, ready-to-play characters for you, and my name is Bianca, here with your guide. To get started, head over to roll20.io/dnd2024 for Roll20 characters and select Dungeons & Dragons 2024 Alpha. Choose from our hero gallery or choose to make your own character. Let's start with Finn at level 1, and you can start from any level on the list you choose. Finn is fully playable with the 2014 rulebooks. The character name, pronouns, level, and details are listed in the upper left. Your proficiency bonus and initiative are at the top to make combat and ability checks simple. You can type in your hit points or use the two heart icons to add and subtract the number. Take a long rest to get those hit points back. You've earned it. You can roll your ability scores on the sheet with the result in the chat panel on the right. If you want to see how you rolled that number, we've broken out each calculation to explain why you got that result. If you use the cog in the upper right, you can override these scores if your DM gives you a homebrew item. The same settings are available for your saving throws. If at any point you need a rule reminder, the question mark icon can grant you some guidance. Roll20 made this sheet collapsible for you to keep the info you need up front quickly, and you can still make rolls. Under skills, your proficiency bonuses are highlighted. You can change your proficiency bonuses by using the cog and choosing to override the number. Proficiency bonuses for items, such as the loot, are automatically rolled for you. Under combat, you have your melee, range, and spell attacks. You can roll your damage from here or in the chat. Send details to the chat with the speech bubble and see the full explanation of the ability with the eye icon. You can set your own custom options here by editing, such as using dexterity for your unarmed strike instead of strength. Add custom attacks, effects, and heals with the plus sign. Track your effects with the toggle or make a note of when you've used an ability with the checkbox. For spells, Roll20 has two views. In the card view, we share more details about that particular spell, which you can expand with Show More. Your saving throw is easy to find to see if your foe has fallen to your insult. In the list view, we've condensed the space to only the spell name. Change to the spell slot view to keep track of your casting. You can prepare your spells under Manage Spells. Since this is a level 1 bard, we don't have much to manage yet. You can also manually add spells to your list and override your ability. Manage your inventory, coin, and weight encumbrance. You can manually add a new item using the red plus sign and make changes using the cog. Features and traits shows what you've learned from your species, class, feats, and backgrounds. For features that have a limited use, you can check them off to keep track. Add in your notes and about details, and Roll20 will remember it for you. For your defenses, you can expand this section to see the details for your armor class and speed. Luckily, we have no active conditions, and Sense summarizes your passive abilities. Get your proficiencies and languages at a glance in the bottom right box. This is the Roll20 Alpha character sheet. Our next release will include the character builder, drag and drop, and much more functionality. Be sure to follow Roll20 on social for the latest updates, and let your DM know that we granted you advantage on your next roll with us.